Well, joining us is Dundee Stars' latest signing for the 2022-23 season. It's Brithin Priest. Brithin, good to have you back in the Stars jersey again. I'm sure you were happy to get things finalised and confirmed for this upcoming season.
Yeah, it was joyous. A lot earlier than I expected, which is quite nice. I have a bit of time to sort of relax and give the mind a rest, but no, it's really really exciting to be settled back in Dundee for the season.
Yeah, do you have those worries when it comes to the end of the season and then no one's really contacted you at first, and then you've got to kind of wait that waiting game, I suppose, to get things finalized in normal circumstances? Is that a bit of a worry for a player?
Yeah, it takes a few weeks like after clubs sort of wind down for the season. And but it's been really hands-on already. Like Jeff got in contact with me, I think, week after the season finished. So, no, it's been nice and sort of relaxed about it this year.
Yeah, I mean, I suppose when Omar had left, there was maybe that worry of, for everybody, uncertainty of where their position would maybe be in terms of the Stars. And for this season, for you, as you say, Jeff contacted you very quickly. That must have showed you that how much he wanted you to be part of this roster and in part of this upcoming season.
Yeah, Joe, it's nice to see if you wanted me, I guess. Right on things. And he contacted us, I think all of the guys from last season in the, to see where the land lies. And then took a few days to get back, and the ball started rolling from there.
And how excited are you about the vision, the plan, and what was said to you from Jeff in those initial discussions?
It's really exciting coming the time for the season. You got a new coach that's got a vision for what he wants to do on and off the ice in Dundee. And I think the guys that are going to come back or new signs out there, really sort of follow that blueprint as well. And you have guys that want to win and want to achieve, or guys that are re-signing that really think they could do something for the club.
Now let's go back to when you started with the Stars. Did you envisage that you would be here a good few numbers years later? We had this similar conversation with Dryden Dow on Friday night, but we know the Dundee Stars is a special place, and it's a place that players find difficult to leave if they do leave, and certainly like to stay if they can. Did you envisage back then, though, that you would be still a Dundee Star at the start of the 2022 season?
Joe, you don't really know what to expect year on year. I mean, it's nice that I've settled on and off the ice up here as a three, or be three seasons now. And yeah, when you're comfortable off the ice, it helps a lot when you turn up to the rink every day. And oh, but something I didn't expect, but it's definitely something I'm enjoying doing.
Let's talk about last season then. Everybody always says, I want our British contingent players to get more ice time. I want them to get ice time. None other than the goaltender. How many times do we hear that? But an opportunity, I suppose, from a bad situation for the Stars where Adam Morrison was injured and you were able to come in and play those games. How do you prepare as the season goes on, Brithin, for that kind of moment? I suppose you do it every week, and you obviously hope it doesn't happen, but when it does, what kind of preparation goes into those kind of weeks when you ain't playing minutes and you've still got to be game ready for when the moment does come?
Yeah, well, you never want to see guys get injured, but sort of the goalie position, it's sort of how it goes, I guess. You've always got to be waiting there, and your chance will come. Just turn up week on week in practice, and just sort of put the work in. And when game time came around last season, it was nice and relaxed, not really much pressure on, and no, it really helped my game.
Yeah, I mean, do you remember that? I know you've talked about it previously in interviews, but talk us through that first game you had last season when you knew you were going to be in between the pipes and the pressure was on you.
It was thrown in at the deep end, really. You had going down to an arena team's rink, and they were chasing that top spot in the league, and we were still trying to find our feet in the playoff race a bit. And sort of, I knew what I'd like to do, know what I have to do in the game, but I just took it save by save, and it was quite nice that I was a bit busy in that game, because it did allow me to find my feet a bit.
I mean, looking at the game, it's mad because there was literally everything to play for both teams. The Stars really needing to find victories to get a playoff spot. And as you say, the other team massively chasing a league title. I mean, it doesn't get any more pressurizing for you going in when arena team in a different arena as well. But I suppose right after that, it really set you up, and the fans got really behind you because, I mean, they'd been crying out for you to get some time to show what you could do. And when you did it, I think there was a real element of proudness from them. And then the next game was unbelievable, wasn't it? In the Dundee Ice Arena, just where the full support was there for you from minute one, I suppose, to minute end.
Yeah, and the fans have been great over my years here in Dundee, but no, they had a lot of support for me in the circumstances last year. I think with going down to Sheffield and taking points there and then coming back home, it's the ball rolling a bit, and it was like we, with where we were chasing to get into the playoffs and then picking up wins like that, it just kept the ball rolling and there was a lot of momentum in the team.
And you know, looking back on the season, reflecting that every point was huge for the Stars last season, and you were a huge part of that. I mean, now the season's over and you're able to reflect on those games, those valuable saves you made for the team that helped them to secure points. You must be pretty proud of yourself for that.
Yeah, so you always want to contribute. I guess over the last sort of few years, it's just you put in the work in practice, but it's nice that it's you don't want to see guys get injured, but when that opportunity comes, it is nice to get some games behind you.
How supportive was Adam Morrison during that period of time for you, in terms of even giving you support off the ice on training days, or maybe talking things through with you? How supportive was he?
Oh, he's been great through under the circumstance too. Like, couldn't meet a nicer guy. It's definitely quite lucky to have a goalie partner like that last season, to sort of know just wants what's best for everybody in the room. And then when that opportunity arose for me, it was, he's right behind me, 100%.
Yeah, that is nice to hear. Now, you've had the itch of playing games for the Stars last season. I'm sure this season you'll be hoping to continue to show your own improvements, develop your game, and also get some more ice time again, I suppose.
Yeah, and that's just day one in training camp. Just work hard every day, and play every practice like it's your last, I guess, and just leave everything out there. And if you keep putting the work in, and I'm sure the games will come next season.
And if I had one final message that you can give to the fans who are watching this tonight, because they've already made some loud noise on social media and delighted that you're back. But what message have you got for them, Brithin?
I see the support over the last few years and in the playoffs, it has been incredible. I keep that up and get behind the team for the next season, and I'm sure it'll be a great season.
Well, Brithin, congratulations on signing again with the Stars. We'll look forward to seeing you in September. And Dundee Stars fans, remember, season tickets are on sale now. Early bird prices remain for a limited time, so grab them before that runs out. And like myself, I'm sure Brithin would like to see you there come September when it all begins.